Welcome to Northside 101, where Northside experts explain complex medical terms and procedures. Today's expert, Dr. Ken Sinervo.
My name is Dr. Ken Sinervo. I'm the medical director for the Center for Endometriosis Care in Atlanta, Georgia. Welcome to Northside 101. I will be talking about endometriosis today. Believe it or not, 1 in 10 women will develop endometriosis over the course of their life, and they will start presenting with symptoms as early as 8 to 10 years old, but we believe that they are actually born with a disease that manifests much later in life.
What is endometriosis?
Endometriosis is a painful condition in which the tissue that's very similar to the lining of the uterus grows outside of the uterus.
What are symptoms of endometriosis?
Symptoms of endometriosis include painful periods. Patients will present with painful periods starting within about 6 months of the onset of their menses, and the pain will progress over time. As well, they'll develop pelvic pain, which is by definition pain that's occurring outside of their menstrual cycle. They'll also have symptoms such as backache, painful intercourse, bowel symptoms such as painful bowel movements, intestinal cramping, even thoracic symptoms such as chest pain with their cycle as well. They can also have collapses of their lung that are secondary to the endometriosis, and even have a fluid-filled chest that's filled with bloody fluid. So it can have symptoms that occur throughout the entire body.
How does endometriosis affect fertility?
Endometriosis can affect fertility in many different ways. We know that it affects women with all stages of the disease. So even patients who have mild disease can have decrease in their fertility from about 85% in the general population down to about 60% chance of conceiving if they have the most mild forms of endometriosis. The chances of conceiving in patients who have severe disease can be less than 5%. And following surgery, fortunately, for all stages of patients who have endometriosis, there will be significant improvement in their chances of conceiving.
How is endometriosis treated, and what is the likelihood of recurrence?
The first line of treatment that we use is usually considered medical treatment, and first line therapy for medical treatment is birth control. If patients have failed birth control trial for approximately 6 months, or they don't tolerate the birth control, then they should be considered a candidate for a laparoscopy. The effective way to treat endometriosis is with a process called excision of endometriosis. And that's what we exclusively use at the Center for Endometriosis Care. We use an energy source. In my case, I use a laser as a cutting tool to make an incision around all the endometriosis, and we cut out the full depth of the disease. Finally, if that fails, some patients do need hysterectomy. Thank you, this is Dr. Sinervo for Northside 101. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. In the meantime, be safe and stay well informed.